Sleeping in Brother's pod. There's not enough space for all three of us. It's fine, Yui. Don't worry so much. You know you want to, really. Look how nice and cozy it is. So warm. Don't you want to cuddle up with Big Brother? Won't it be nice? Let's climb in then. Yuka. It's okay. Right, Big Brother? You don't mind sharing the bed with both of us, do you? With your two cute little sisters. I'm sure there will be enough space. I knew it. You couldn't resist a chance like this, could you? Of course you couldn't. I bet Brother's a pervert. What? Like I was saying, it's been so long since we all slept together. I missed it. All the times when we were little, before you started shutting yourself away so much. It gets so hard to see you in between school. I miss you. And Yui did too. You call. Not really. That's a lie. You love Big Brother just as much as I do. And we brought you some tea as well. I thought if you really were awake at this time, you probably were having trouble sleeping. But it'll be okay now that we're here. Yuka and Yui will make you feel all better. Yui, sit down. There's not much space. Then come sit closer. Don't be so shy. You didn't used to be like this, Yui. Big Brother has two hands. One for your head, and one for mine. We can share. Yuka. I still don't know. It's kinda strange. But it's so cozy. We're not little kids anymore. Nice and sleepy, Yuka. So warm. But we can't forget about the tea. I'll pour some for all three of us now. I'll do it. It's fine. No. I mean, you don't need to worry about that. It's closer to me anyways. You focus on getting comfy here. Okay. Um, sugar. I like it very sweet. And so does Yui. No, she doesn't like to admit it. She told kids in our class that she drinks coffee black. And I still see her sneak extra sugar into her tea. Yuka. Don't. I'm just teasing. I love you, Yui. And I love you too, big brother. Now, here's your tea. Drink up. Every last drop. I made this with my love for my two favorite people in the whole world. Thank you. And for you too, big brother. Drink up. Is it good? It's nice. Thank you, Yuka. I'll take a sip myself. Yummy. You too, drink up too. Drink up, big brother. Do you like it too, big brother? This is my special tea that I made especially for you. Treat before bed. I think I put a little more sugar in than you usually have because I think something sweet is really nice once in a while. Thank you. You look happy, Yui. Smile like that in a long time. You really do like it here with Big Brother. No, it's just the tea. It's delicious. Really? Yes. I only came here because you wanted to. What kind of disgusting things could have happened if you slept with brother all alone? What's that supposed to mean? Never mind. Yui. Yuka. But I know you don't mean it really. You're really happy, really. Yui? That's not true. You can't lie to me. I'm your twin sister. I know every little thing about you. Clearly not everything. Tomorrow. We can't. We'd get in trouble, Yuka. But we'll have to get up in 4 hours if we go. Just one day. It's so cozy and warm in this bed. I don't ever want to leave. Maybe I won't. Let's just stay here with Big Brother forever and ever. Not silly. You don't want to? No. That's a lie, Yui. Admit it. It's not. Then why are you blushing? it's dark. You can't even see my face. You shouldn't lie about everything so much, you know. It's bad for you. It's okay. It's just me and Big Brother here. It's okay to give in and enjoy things sometimes. We don't got to do this anymore. We haven't got to sleep in Big Brother's bed in so long. So we should appreciate this while we can, I think. That's a yes? I guess. I can always make you give in to me, Yui. Hey, Big Brother. The last time we did this, it was 6 years ago, wasn't it? I think about that time a lot. Even though it was so long ago, and it's kind of silly now, I still remember every detail. It made me feel really, really happy. It was a night kind of like this, too. It was raining outside. Storming as well. I was really scared, see? And so was Yui. So we didn't want to sleep in our beds alone anymore. Do you remember, Yui? Yeah. Yui was different then. She was actually the one that said she wanted to sleep in your bed. She was crying a lot, like a little baby. You call. Sorry, but it's true. So I held her hand, and I was really, really brave. We started to walk across the hall. Flash of lightning. It was so scary too. All in the dark like that. My legs were shaking really badly. I really remember it. Yui was holding onto my hand so tightly that my fingers went numb. Yuka was crying really loudly. Snot everywhere. Yui, now you know what it's like. And then, before we could reach the door, you opened it, Big Brother. I've never ever felt so happy to see you before. I just wanted to hug you and never let go. I loved you lots and lots in that moment, Big Brother. I felt like my heart was going to burst out of my chest. And it was like this then. We all slept in your bed together. And it was so warm and nice just like now. I slept so well. I wasn't even scared at all anymore. Remember that part so well. makes me feel sad to think about. Brother always said that we were too old to hang out now, to be together like this. Though he was the only one who changed. Yeah. Boys change a lot as they get bigger, though. So it's okay. We have Big Brother right now, though. So that's all that matters. Normal teenage boys aren't stay-at-home meats who sit in their room and watch anime all day. Don't be so mean all the time, Yui. You love Big Brother, really. You're just... tsundere. I'm not. But that's what a tsundere would say. I'm not your stupid anime thing. It's every now and again. School is really boring and kind of scary. Lots of people have been talking about strange things in town lately. Have you heard about it? It's all been happening for a while now. Another girl went missing this week. She was in our year too. A boy was attacked by his girlfriend. It makes me feel really scared. I'm quite popular at school, you know, Big Brother. Lots of boys try to talk to me, but I always turn them down. So if something bad ever happened to me, you'd come and save me, right? You wouldn't let your cook get hurt, would you? Are you? couldn't you? From the bad, bad people outside. Just like you protected us all those years ago. When it was storming. And if something bad ever happened, Big Brother, I'd do anything. There's nothing that I wouldn't do for Big Brother, and for you too. But if someone ever even thought about hurting my dear, precious Big Brother, anymore. It's a little mean, I know, but just the thought, it makes me feel really, really angry that someone would try to hurt Big Brother or take him away from me and Yui, because I love Big Brother. Why someone as nice and handsome as Big Brother doesn't have a girlfriend? Because you have me and Yui, right? You don't need to love anyone else. So much still, it makes me really, really sad. I feel so alone sometimes. I need my beloved Big Brother back. Like things used to be. And Yui feels the same too. Don't you, Yui? She's not very good at seeing things like this. So I have to make sure to see it for her. Even if I'm really tired now. You go. Hang right. Aren't I? I guess. I knew it. You're so shy, Yui. Thank you. fast asleep. We're finally alone, my dearest brother. Do you have any idea how long I've waited for this moment? I've wanted to be alone with you. This is the day that I've been waiting for all of my life. Yuka really is an idiot. She insisted on pouring the tea. And yet, she still ended up drugging herself. And she still ended up giving you the sedative. She had a 66% chance of either killing or knocking me out. And still, everything went perfectly to plan. Probably kind of confused right now, aren't you, brother? Well, of course you would be. You never pay any attention to me, do you? This whole time, you've been looking at her. I can't really blame you. Even if we're identical twins, Yuka's still cuter than me. Yuka's kinder, sweeter, louder than me. Everyone at school flocks to her too. I'm just Yui. No, not even that. To everyone, I'm just Yuka's sister, and nothing more. But it's the same to you. It's the same to you too, right, brother? It's her that you pay attention to, just like everyone else. It's her that you love the most, just like everyone else. And maybe it's kind of mean to do this to her. Maybe you would have noticed my regret if you'd been paying more attention to me. She doesn't mean to act the way she does. She loves me too. I know it. But with you, Carl, I never have a chance. I can't compete against her. That's this, or live my entire life in her shadow. I tried so hard to make you notice me, my dear brother. I did everything that I could to shift your attention in my direction. Even if it was just for a little while. It got harder as we all got older, as you started shutting yourself away more. Not even Yuka could get your attention now. But a few years ago, when you were still going to school, I pretended to be sick and stayed off alone. I sneaked into your room and looked through every inch to try and figure you out. I found some interesting things on your computer. When I realized that you had a sister complex from all of the hentai, I was overjoyed. learned that you were such a pervert. But when I found out you also had a thing for cold, mean girls, I tried my very hardest to become one myself. Just for you. What's the term you got used again? Tsundere. Well, I tried. But still, wasn't it good enough? I tried so hard. But even though I became the girl of your dreams, a cruel, mean, tsundere little sister, that still wasn't enough. Not enough to drag your attention away from Yuka. Not even for a little. Whether you meant to or not, it was always obvious to me that she's your favorite. I guess the real world just isn't the same as anime. But oh well. Everything worked out in the end. I had to take some drastic measures. But I have you now, my dearest brother. From now on, it'll just be me. You still love me, right, brother? I know that you did, that you always did, of course. But I'm tired of being second best to my perfect, innocent, adorable sister. She never realized how I am, really. I wonder if she'd realized she would have tried to fix it. Jealousy hurts. It must hurt for the person you love the most to not love you at all. But it hurts even more for the person you love to love you second best. Now that Yuka's gone, she's still breathing, but it won't be for long. The drug that I slipped into her tea will just suffocate her in her sleep. It's peaceful, so don't worry. She won't feel a thing. She'll die with her beloved big brother and Yui to her side, perfectly content. And I'll finally get to be happy. So it's really not that bad, is it? Everyone wins in the end. You get to have the little sister of your dreams. I get to be loved by the person I love the most. And sweet little Yuka stays happily oblivious. Forever. Struggling to stay awake too. The sedative I gave you was really strong, just in case. You'll wake up in a few days, and everything will be fine. I'll take care of you from now on. I promise. So, good night, brother.